Hi, this is JB Morin from the University of Nice. I'm going to present you our spreadsheet for force, velocity, power, profiling in sprinting. The entire computations are based on this paper, a simple method for measuring force, power, velocity, and mechanical effectiveness in sprint running by Pierre Samosino and colleagues last year. And basically, if you want to access this paper, you can download it here on ResearchGate. So basically, the procedure detailed here in this box requires you to enter some variables in the yellow cells here and 5 meter split times over a 30 meter. So basically here, I'm going to enter my height, I'm going to enter my body mass, the temperature on the day of testing, and the air pressure. That's for friction computations. Once I have done this, basically I need to fill the split times here. So that's going to be 6 split times. But if you want to use only 5, 10, 20, and 30 meter, it's also possible. But let's go with 6 splits. So my 5 meter time was 1.5, let's say, 01. My 10 meter time, 2.49. My 15 meter time was 3.142. Then the 20 meter time was 3.852. The 25 meter time was 4.548. And finally, the 30 meter time was 5.249. So once you have done this, basically here on the right side of the sheet, you have the position as a function of time. And here will appear the split times. And as you can see here, the 6 split times are not correctly modeled by the exponential function. So I need to set the Vmax and tau variables so that the exponential function is fitting the data correctly. Because basically all the other computations that you see here, the force velocity profile, the power output, the ratio of force, which is an index of effectiveness, everything is computed from this displacement as a function of time curve. So basically the adjustment, the fitting will be done by the Excel solver, because the Excel solver is an Excel add-in that you can install, of course, and the Excel solver will fit this time position curve to the actually measured time at the different splits. So basically, to run the solver, you need to open the solver and ask the solver to minimize the square differences between the model data and the actual data. And to minimize that, the solver will optimize Vmax value and tau value. Vmax and tau are variables of this exponential function. If you need more details, just report to the and just go and check the paper. So I will open the solver. It's in data. Solver. If it's not installed on your Excel version, you need to install it. It's an add-in macro. So I want the sum of square differences to be equal to the value 0, and I want the solver to play on Vmax and tau variables. So once this is set correctly, you click on solve, and the solver will propose you one solution here. You see that the sum of square differences is almost 0, which means that the fitting of the exponential function to the real split time is almost perfect. And that's what you want. You want to have this almost perfect fitting, because everything else afterwards is computed from this fitting. So what you understand now is that I went from 6 split times to the entire time function. And I chose in this file a time resolution of 1/100th of a second, which is accurate enough. So once this is done, of course, you can save your file. And here, automatically, every graph has updated. And you have here the force velocity power curve of your athlete. You have the velocity as a function of time. You have the horizontal force output and the horizontal power. And you see here, the peak power is reached around 1 second. And the value of the peak power is 12 watts per kilogram. So in this box here, you have basically the main results of the force velocity power profile. F0 is the theoretical horizontal maximum force, V0 is the theoretical maximum speed, Pmax is the power, and you have also ratio of force maximum, 38%, which is an indicator of how the force is applied onto the ground, what is the effectiveness of propulsion. The DRF is how this effectiveness decreases with time during acceleration. And here, Vopt is the optimal speed. It's the speed at which my power output is maximum. So then, if you want to read more on how to interpret this data, you can go and see this paper that I've written with Pierre Samosino. In this paper, we explain everything about the normal values, normative data, and how you can implement training based on this force velocity assessment. Two more informations. First, the normative values for F0 are between, let's say, 4 or 5 newtons per kilo for untrained people, to 10 or 11 newtons per kilo in elite sprinters and elite people. So that's very important, because if you find some F0 data that are above 12 newtons per kilo, something went wrong with the timing, and I will come back to this later. Typically, the maximum power output in a very sprint-trained individual is around 20 watts per kilo. Best world sprinters reach 30 watts per kilo. Same thing, if you find something that's beyond these values for untrained people or low-level people, that's something not normal. So now let's go back to something interesting. If you only measure 5, 10, not 15, but 20, and not 25, but 30, let's say you have only 4 split times and not 6, which is to me the minimum, well, you can run exactly the same computations here, except that instead of having 6 points, you will have only 4. But still, you see that if you run the solver again, you can have a very good agreement with only 4 split times. Here, this is acceptable. And if you save the value, you have a pretty low sum of squared differences here. Well, let me suppress that. Sorry for that. Here, so you suppress the entire line of data, you run the solver again, and you try to have this optimization based on only 4 split times. So it works, but my opinion is that if you have 6 split times, especially at the beginning of the sprint, it's going to be better. Now let's come back to the accuracy here. This is a very important note. All these computations are based on the fact that the first split, the 5-meter split, is measured with a time triggered with the first motion of the subject. So it means that your splits must be triggered with, let's say, a foot pressure pad or something that makes the time run as soon as any propulsive motion is produced by the athlete. So typically, if your split times begin with the first pair of timing gates 20 centimeters, 50 centimeters in front of the athlete, well, you have an overestimation of the 5-meter splits, and this will impact F0 and Pmax variables a lot. So basically, if you're not able to have a proper trigger of the split times when the sprint actually begins, you should not use this spreadsheet. My advice is that if you have access to the MySprint app, you can use also MySprint to compute the split times, and then you can use the spreadsheet to have a clear, comprehensive access to the entire force, velocity, power profile. Well, that's it. If you want to read more, of course, you have access to the papers, and I hope you can use this this spreadsheet easily. And of course, improve this spreadsheet and adapt it to your practice. Bye-bye.